Hi and welcome to the channel. Today we will unbox, mount, and test this ID Cooling IS60 EVO ARGB. In case you are like Linus Tech Tips who just knew this brand recently,
I had never heard of ID Cooling before.
ID Cooling is a Chinese brand that offers a lot of options for low profile cooling. Around the box you will see some dimension specifications. So you can see that it is 64mm in height. They will also tell you a lot of dimensions, but just to cut it short, the fan is 120mm on the top and 92mm on the bottom. TDP rating is 130 watts, and this version supports an LGA 1700 bracket. And then you can see some specs on one side as well. Opening the box, it's padded by a thin foam, an accessory kit, and a manual, which is very important for coolers as this will tell you how to mount the cooling solution to your CPU. So let's open the accessory kit. So the accessory kit has this is probably an AM4 backplate. This for an Intel LGA bracket. Their thermal paste, which is very light. Not sure if it has contents. Does another set of mounting brackets. So this seems to be for, so you'll know that it is an LGA 1700 bracket if there's a label of 1700. So this is for LGA 1200 and 115X. Then the AM4 will usually look a bit taller than the LGA counterpart. Some screws and standoffs, then a sticker. So this is the cooler itself. The cooler has two fans, one on the bottom and one on the top. Both are 15mm in height. So as told earlier, the top is 120mm and the bottom is 92mm. The top fan is an ARGB fan for extra performance. And because there are two fans and one is an ARGB for that matter, expect some cable mess with it. Also notice that because there are two fans, the heatsink is just probably around 22 millimeters, which also means that this is not so thick. Anyway, let's try to mount this. For mounting test, I will be using a B550i Aorus Pro AX. This is actually the only ITX motherboard I have. As for the processor, I'll be using a Ryzen 7 5800X. So 5800X and a low profile cooler doesn't sound compatible or doesn't sound optimal, but remember that the rating of the cooler is 130 watts and the rating of the CPU is 105 watts. Although there are no standards in TDP rating, based on specs, it should be able to handle this. Although I really doubt, but I'll test it anyway. So let's remove the plastic. So the manual did not say how should I orient the brackets, but I'm assuming it to be this way. So brackets installed. Based on the instruction, I have to remove the existing backplate. So next, I have to apply some thermal paste. And try to mount it this way. So do an acrobatics, turn your motherboard upside down and align the holes if you can. So it has some tightening nuts, but I don't know which one to use, so I'll try the taller one first. So use the taller one for AM4. This is probably for Intel. Okay, installation is done. What's next is to plug this connector. So it has a very long cables. They're basically giving you a Y connector, Y splitter. Then just plug this to the motherboard. Then plug the RGB to the motherboard as well, which is, in my case, it's here. So as you can see, there are many cables. So that's one disadvantage of having two fans, and one of those is an RGB fan. I'll test this if this configuration is optimal for 5800X. As for the RAM, I think I should also test now as well. As for the RAM, I'll be using the usual Kingston Fury 32GB DDR4 3600 mega transfers per second CL18 RAM. This is a very good looking compact build. Anyway, I'll test this setup for now. Okay, as for post-installation comments, first be very careful with your pairing, especially to your motherboard. As can be seen in my mounting, this cooler can barely fit this motherboard. If your motherboard has a mezzanine, like the Z690 ITX motherboards out there, I really doubt that this would fit. Although you can flip the cooler upside down, will then have issues in your PC case as it will gain a substantial height. Next is ease of mounting. Overall, I don't like it since your CPU cannot be easily swapped out. Although take note that this is normal for low profile coolers and it's not against this cooler alone. But I like the mounting at the back as it is not protruding unlike the EXP90. It seems that I will not have a problem with this cooler. However, as there are two sets of so-called tightening nuts, their term, not mine, I actually don't know which set is for AM4 and which set is for LGA. Although you won't make mistakes since the LGA ones will not fit in AM4, I still think ID cooling could do a better job, similar to Arctic, where they had some simple indicators which ones are for AM4 and which ones are for Intel. Also, I would rather call these screws other than nuts. They also did not mention about the AM4 backplate in the manual, and they ask you to put washer instead, which is not included. Next is the noise. It does make an audible noise, not as loud as EXP90, but still loud. With that, I will try to swap out the fans in my upcoming ITX build. Next is the probable market for this cooler and why I tested it with 5800X. So I believe that the 5800X and its class is the target market for this cooler, which I can summarize as basically hot processors without stock coolers. I don't think this is a good candidate for a stock cooler replacement for coolers like EXP90-X47-X36 and Noctua L9. I could forgive them for handling 65 watts TDP only since you may have height constraints in your PC case and thus your stock cooler needs to be replaced. However, this cooler is taller than the stock cooler. And if you're an overclocker, I don't think you should go for a low profile cooler. Maybe buy a Chungus air cooler or go for liquid cooling. And with that, I think this is really weak in terms of value against the free stock cooler. And so in my simple mind, this is built for processors without stock cooler and those with the 95 to 105 watts TDP processors. Finally, the thermals. The thermals are actually okay during a battery of test, which includes Cinebench R23, FF15 benchmark, and an actual CSGO gameplay. IS60 averaged at around 75 degrees Celsius. There was only one moment, like for 1 second or so, where it reached 80 degrees Celsius. Overall, this is very competitive with my Arctic Esports 34 Duo, as the IS60 trails by 4 degrees Celsius only. For me, this is actually very impressive for its size. So overall, I would recommend this for SFF builds that are air-cooled and your processor has no stock cooler and you're below 105 watts TDP. Outside those instances, maybe not. This is also not cheap at 2,000 pesos since you can get an Arctic Esports 34 at 2,200 pesos. Okay, so that's it for my unboxing. Thanks for watching. Do like or dislike, comment on what you think, and subscribe for more unboxing and benchmarks. Bye!